I'm back. Please tell me that you guys got to see me kill that motherfucker, because that was good. That was really good. Oh my god. Okay. So, you know how I didn't talk to Ganessa when I got here? I did that for a reason. I wanted to see if I could actually, do something. I want to see if I can do it. If I use my tarnished mark, will it send me back to the actual... Yes, it will.
Yes.
The glands right here. It's just not glowing red for some reason. What I did was I used my teleportation to get myself out of there so I didn't have to do that old fucking run again. Now I just need to get myself back to the hub. I hope it didn't fuck up my gland. Oh no, it definitely did not. Okay. Because these guys were not here before. Okay. I gotta get myself out of here. Fucking bell. right on my right side. Get out of my face. You know. Problem is, where the fuck do I go? Get off of me. It's always very annoying. It's also more foggy than it usually is. Get out of my way! Merchant guy upstairs has it. That's crazy, though. Yeah, like I said, though, like, if I was at least to use Solomon, I think I would have been able to get him my first try. Okay, now I need to remember which way I have to go. I think it's past the big frog. Up when I hit him. Yeah, I think it did. Shit. Damn it, it fucked me up. Okay, whatever. I hate when enemies do that. I was told that if I was to beat him three rats and play my lyre, something would happen. And I think it was about to happen, but those guys just came out of fucking nowhere. And that's bullshit when that happens. It's okay, I can always try and get more rest on my off time. Another type of loot? Really? I'd have to take a look at that. Let's give that a shot. So there's two different kinds of loots. Simple loot. Impervious loot. Okay. We'll put it there. Well, seeing how Solomon learns things faster, let's see what happens. Yeah, he does. Instead of one notch, it's two. Not bad, actually. Alright, let's keep using it. It's okay, man. I'm actually glad that you've been coming over and everything. Also, I did want to say something before you left, Becker, if you have a few minutes. I have a couple goals for 2022 that I wanted to talk to my mods and my current subscribers about and everything. Even though I sadly lost two subscribers during my away leave, which is sad, but things happen. My next subscriber goals, I'm going to be trying to save up for Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon and Five Nights at Freddy's Security Breach. But when it comes to Five Nights at Freddy's Security Breach, I want to wait until the next patch comes out because it's very, very buggy right now. Security Breach, aside from VR, are the only two I haven't played. I'm not going to play VR because, problems with my head. Those are technically my first subscriber goals for 2022. Just trying to save up for those games. Also, in my Discord, in my games want list, I added a few games as well that I'd like to add to that. So if anybody wants to help me get those games to stream one day, you know, let me know. I accept subscriptions, bits, things of that nature. I'm hoping to get back some of my subscribers that I lost last year. Like I said, I lost one. The person knows who he is. I'm hoping he'll come back sooner or later. I'm not going to say the person's name. But I also lost two additional subscribers over my hospitalization month. So I hope I'll be able to gain them back. If I don't, it's fine. It's not a complete big deal. It'll just take me longer to get the games that people would like to see me stream. But we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. But yeah. I just thought I'd let you guys know all that, before you leave, of course, Becker. I like trying to keep everybody in the loop. Loot is life. Oh, I can change the music, dude. I said that I could change the music. That's kind of weird. Yeah. But I think my only subs I have now is, I have Shadow Seed. I have, hold on. I want to check to see who all I have left. Yes, I have Shadow Seed. I have Zachary Danger, Geek Most Random, and my friend James. Basically, I went from technically 7 subs to 4, which is kind of sad. But like I said, things happen. Hopefully, they'll return one day. I know, I didn't want to mention you. You were the person I was talking about that I didn't want to mention. Because I know your situation. The other people, I just don't like it when they don't want to communicate with me. Makes me think I did something wrong. That's all. Yeah. It's all good, man. Like I said, no one is ever obligated to subscribe or anything like that. Just keep that in mind. Just understand that there's games that people want me to play and they want me to stream, but it's gonna take me a while to get those. Cause I've been getting a lot of recommendations, and I'm like, I'll put it on the list, but you're gonna have to probably wait on those. Cause I don't stream for money. I stream to give people a good environment, and you know, I consider all of you like my friends and family and everything. So yeah. Okay, so that's a dead end. Let me double check this real quick before I head out. I'm actually glad that I got some extra stuff. That's pretty good. This is still locked. There's supposed to be a chest under there, but it's okay. Yeah, Becker, you have yourself a good night, man. Yes, please stay in touch. Why do you look weird there? That's weird. Okay. Alright, let me heal him a little bit more now that I don't have anything attacking my butt. Alright, so came from that way. Let's go this way for right now. See what's up here. Okay. Oh, we got a big dude right here. I'm actually kind of glad that I switched to Solomon. Honestly, one of the reasons why I wanted to switch to Solomon is because I know that Shadow Seed is playing this in his own free time. And he said that he's been playing with Solomon. And I'm starting to understand why he he's very nimble, and he's able to do more specials. I like that. Ah, fuck. Get out of me. Oh, you're gonna pay for that. Where'd you go? Love the combo that you can do with the heavy attack. Like while you're charging up your heavy attack, you can harden. And if you're targeted at the right enemy, it does a big amount of damage for free. I really like that. That's gotta be my favorite thing to do in this game. Honestly, I kinda wish that Dark Souls had that. That'd be cool. Shield up, and if something bounces off your shield, the next attack that you would do before putting up your shield, you know what I mean? Like that would be kind of cool. Slurry of Tar. Okay. Okay, let me make sure I'm going the right way. So how I know if I'm going the right way? I look for Mr. Frog, and I go from there. Mr. Frog. I went that way. Went that way, I believe. Yeah. Is there anything around here I should know? Yeah, there's a hole over here. What's in the hole? What is that? Oh, I've been here. Where I fucked up last time, I think. Right. Yeah, this is where I fucked up last time. Yeah, I don't want to go here. Yeah, I'd rather not do that. I think also one of the reasons why I was having issues with my stream is also some of the areas I go to, the frame rate probably goes down exponentially. So that might be another reason why I was losing some of my stream. It was because of the area I was in. That could be a possibility. Okay, so Mr. Frog is over here, right? Yeah, there's Mr. Frog. Went that way. Went this way. Okay. So there's that way. Up here. What is over here? That's the dead end, I think. Yeah, that's the dead end. Okay, so I know where I need to go. this is sending me in a fucking circle. Because Mr. Frog will be over here. Correct? Yeah. This is sending me in an interesting little spiral. Okay. So let me... You see what all's up here? I think there was two holes, right? There was this hole, and... no. Is this the hole that has where I fucked up at? Yeah. You know one thing that would be so fucking useful for this game? And it also would have been so amazingly useful in Dark Souls. It's the one thing that they both lack. A map. If this had a map... Oh, that would be amazing. Absolutely amazing. Okay. So let me see. I need to try and figure out where I have to go. Mr. Frog's there. I really think it's over here somewhere. There's gotta be something that I'm missing. That I'm not seeing. This was the dead end. Is there anything I can break over here? Because the reason I'm going over here is this is the only area I have not been to. From my lack of judgment, of course. I hate how these bags keep moving. That's weird. I have to figure out where to go. This doesn't really look familiar. What's this? Yeah, this doesn't look very familiar to me. Let's go this way and see what happens. Off, man. getting glimpses of them. I do like that. Just a little thing to tell you all, you know, even the ones watching on YouTube. I honestly don't care whether or not you subscribe or not, or give bits or anything like that. Just keep in mind that if you do recommend something to me to play, of course I will put it on my list. I always put everything I do on my list. It's just, you know, it'll take me longer to do your request. If I'm doing it by myself, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, if you want to help out with that, you know, you can subscribe, give bits, whatever you want to do. It's your choice, you know. Because I've had people ask me, like, privately, like, why I haven't played this or why I haven't done that. And I've had to tell them, I'm like, you know, trying to keep everybody happy is almost literally impossible. You know? I can't get to everybody's requests here and there. Even if I found a way to clone myself, it would be, like, you know, nearly impossible. Let me go up here real quick. I want to beat up these guys that keep using these fucking arrows if I can. How do I get to them? Over here, I'm guessing. Haha, you're dead. Okay. Come on, bastard. Oh, come on. Another little example, I have an almost lifetime fan in the chat right now. He's lurking right now. His name is Mr. Rumble Roses, and he's seen me play every single FNAF game except for FNAF VR and, of course, now Security Breach. I would love to find a way to play Security Breach for Rumble. Because while, you know, on YouTube, people are like, oh, you know, Markiplier's the king of Five Nights at Freddy's. Not exactly. Nothing against Mark Edward Fishbach. You know, nothing against Mr. Fishbach. But the only reason he got that title is because of some of the stuff he did for, like, 2020 food and things like that. I had to practice a lot to be good at FNAF back in the day. And one day I actually do want to do a FNAF tier list. That would be pretty fun. Because I've played every single one except for, of course, VR. Yes, I've also played FNAF World. Wasn't much of a fan of it, but I could understand what Mr. Coffin was trying to do. Plus, I used to be my own version of a FNAF theorist. You know, of course, there's, you know, there's people like, you know, MatPat and Doggo and Razbowski and 8-Bit Ryan and all that. You know, I get it. But here's the thing, though, is my theories kind of made a little bit more sense, but it kept changing a lot when Coffin kept, just changing things. So, like, for example, when it came to the original, I'd say the original three, I used to think that you played as a detective, and you kept going to the different establishments. You know, of course, like, after everything went down. But of course that changed when he did FNAF 4, which I loved FNAF 4. FNAF 4 was amazing. I think Rumble back in the day liked FNAF 3 because of the whole thing with Springtrap. But I could be completely wrong. I think, Rumble, didn't you always have a rivalry with, I think, Chica? Because my rivalry was always with, literally, Golden Freddy. Like, I've no doubt. He just appeared out of fucking nowhere. Just, like, fucking teleported. Is this ready to go? Oh, this looks new. Where is this going to go? This looks a little bit different. I hope I'm going the right fucking way. Nope, I am not going the right way. Because I recognize that chest. I've got to figure out where to fucking go. Yeah, that's a lot of dead people. Ow. I gotta figure out where to go. I thought going to where the frog was going to be what I needed to do, but apparently not. Apparently not. I'll figure out more stuff along the way. Off stream, if I have to, I'll get more mushrooms and stuff like that. Come at me, home slice. The fuck off. Have that. Get out of here with that shit. Wish you could open these boxes. That'd be pretty snazzy. Did I ever go that way? Let's find out. Eat one of these in case I get poisoned. Hi-ho, hi-ho, it's off to work we go. Technically, I am lost. No. I've been killing the hell out of sons of bitches here, man. I like the music here, though. Well, not the music, the ambient sounds. Sounds are nice. Gotta figure out where to go. I would think, though, that it'd be the frog that I'd have to go through. But it's not. Because I was trying to remember, I'm like, you know, that's the only place that I could think of that I've never been. Say this though, if this was Dark Souls 2, I wouldn't have bitched so much about Dark Souls 2. I cannot believe I'm actually saying this. I'm wishing that Dark Souls 2 was Mortal Shell. Never thought I'd be saying that. Yeah. also, out of practicing a lot of the other weapons you can get in this game, I've only gotten, I think it's 3 out of 4. Which is the hollow sword, the hammer and chisel, and the hollow sword. Not the hollow sword, martyr blade. I have my little thoughts on stuff. Where's this guy at? Oh, there he is. Oh, fuck off, man. I haven't done much practice with the hammer and chisel, but honestly, I kind of like using the hollow sword the most. And it's very funny as to why. Because in my opinion, I've seen a lot of the different specials that you can get, and I have my own thoughts on those specials. I like stuff that's quick and powerful, I guess you could call it. Oh, fuck off, dude. Getting some items, though, which is nice. Okay, so I've been here already. I don't need to go this way. Check to see if there's anything here that I missed, though. Not so far. Okay. So I don't need to go this way, because I've already gotten everything from this area. I've already fought the boss in this area. So I don't need to go that way. I definitely don't need to go in the catacombs part, because I already fought that boss. I just need to figure out literally where I need to go next. And I'll adapt to that as I get to it. Oh, it's just a locked stone chest or whatever. I could see not having a map being one of the biggest complaints about Mortal Shell. I could see that. It does promote you to explore more, which I do understand. It's just when you want to get somewhere, it is very, it's very tedious when you get lost. Makes you want to be like, you know what, I need to walk away from this. But, you know, it is what it is, I guess. I don't even know what it's called that I have to get to. I'm just trying to find something that I haven't explored yet. How did I go around a fucking circle? That's so frustrating. That's frustrating. Okay, let's figure something out here. Can't just roam around with my dick in my hand, so I gotta figure something out here. Go this way, see what happens. Mr. Frog, I wish you could tell me where to go. You know, that would be absolutely astounding. Aside from just being there to mess with my audio settings and do some unknown thing with rats that I don't even understand what to do. On the bright side, at least I'm getting me some tar. If I can get to 8,000 tar, that'd be pretty cool. I'll be able to get those tools or whatever they are to fix up that ballista zooka type of thing. I don't need to go see Sister Vanessa. Also, there's another reason why I'm killing a lot of stuff right now. I'm killing a lot of stuff so I know where I've been and where I haven't been. Take that. That gives me only one will cap. Some places that you can go, you can get two. I'm getting items off of a lot of the guys I'm killing, so that's good. I just don't like the fact that I still haven't found out where to go. I could go this way. forward, keep finding more enemies we haven't killed. I think that'll be the ticket that I'm looking for. Look for people I haven't killed. And that'll lead me down the path I need to go. I do remember this area. Come on with that shit. God, I love how strong my sword is right now. This was around where I went to the underground catacombs. So I do remember this area. I never did explore it though. Trying to assert your dominance on me, big boy. Okay, so over here, let me see if I'm doing this right. So come into this area would be right here. I think down this way is where the this is starting to look like where I need to go. This was an area that I hadn't fully explored. If you remember, all I did was run through here to get underground. But I know straight ahead, that'll send me underground. I got a glimpse for that. Very cool. Okay. Alright, so need to remember not to go that way. I need to check out the right and left pathways. Yeah. kill all you guys, though. To walk up first. Two of you want to, okay. Oh, can I get both? Ooh, double kill, man. Oh, that was very satisfying. You have no idea how satisfying that was. Okay. Oh. Thank you. go back soon, though. Oh, that's not good. It'll just bounce off. Also, in February, I'm going to be trying to get myself a new television set. The flat screen that I use for streaming and stuff like that, it's just way too small. And, you know, my eyes can't always see everything. So, there's that. Okay, so, that... unless that is a way that I have to go. I mean, it's kind of looking like it. But, I don't know yet. The merchant guy at the hub was actually found over here. Alright guys, let's pray that this is the right way to go, because there's no other way I can find. Nope. I'm back at square one. I really wish this game would literally be able to tell me where to go. This is very annoying, to be honest with you. There we go. Alright, let's see what this does, actually. Alright, what are you gonna do to me, Frogo? Oh. Oh! Nice. The count. Oh, that's cool. So if I give different types of food, am I gonna get a different skin? Let's test this out. Feed him the boiled frog. What does that do? Ow! Oh. Okay, let's not feed him the boiled frog. Yeah, that was a bad idea. Okay. Don't feed a frog boiled frog. Okay. Okay, now I gave him rotten food. And what is he going to do? Okay, that just puts me back in my original skin. Interesting. Yeah, that wasn't bad taste. You're right. I shouldn't have done. You're not gonna know something until you try, you know what I mean? That's why I did that. That was kind of cool, though, the red shade. I wonder how I can get that back. That was actually kind of cool. So now we know what happens when you feed particular things to that giant frog. You get different skins for your clothing, for your shell. That's cool. Yeah, someone on Twitter told me, hey, you know, you should feed 3 roasted rat to the frog. Why? He's like, I don't know, you should find out. I'm like, okay. So apparently that's what happens. That was kind of cool. I'm wondering that now as well, yeah. Kind of wondering that myself. I really don't want to switch to the game now, sadly. I'm getting so used to Solomon. I'm just glad I'm not having any more strength problems right now. I want to go back. Not bad. I know a couple places where I can get, where I can farm some mushrooms. Got one there. Okay, so this is where I would go to go to the underground. There's nothing else in the underground for me. Definitely not gonna fall into water, because I know that'll fucking kill me. That's some deep ass water. I would sink like a rock. Yes, I said that to be funny. Speed regeneration. Okay. Regeneration speed for 3 minutes. Okay, so boiled frog helps out with speed. Okay. That doesn't surprise me. I do need to use these mortal tokens, though. I know I'm wasting items, but I'm doing all this so I can unlock its actual ability. What's that? in places where there's still enemies left. I've been killing the hell out of stuff. But when I think of rotten food, I think of that scene from from Judge Dredd, Sylvester Stallone, where there's these little robots that walk around and they say eat recycled food. Recycled food or whatever. It's kind of funny. I'll go up those stairs in a minute and we'll see what else is up here. Fuck off. Oh, there's a big boy. Okay, two big boys, actually. Let's go. Those two dudes. think about going into another area. I need to check out what's up those stairs. Anything I need to loot? No. Destroy all your stuff. Okay. Alright, let's see what we got here. Let's see what's up the steps. Anything over here? No. There's some shit above me, though. Officially found where we needed to go. Awesome. And there's Ganessa.
You've kept me waiting, foundling. Do not worry. 'Tis only a jest.
Oh, it's fine.
This path ahead is littered with monuments to suffering. Thought I might lighten the mood. Not that I've ever had much talent for humor. I once knew a man who took the sacrament of ashes. He laughed all the time. Now I'm rambling like an old crone. You're here for another sip, aren't you?
Sure. I gotta lock something. Put your enemies off balance with a powerful kick. Okay. I know, right? That caught me off guard too. Yeah. Recollection of knowledge. If I could get to that many glimpses. Let me check something real quick. Let me check about my glimpses here. Because I've gotten a few. I have mods. Shadow, I want you to go on Google for me. I want you to tell me what the tattered vestment does. What's that unlimited use item do? While you do that, I'm gonna look for some more stuff to play with here. Let's see, glimpse of insignificance. Sure. That did it. That definitely did it.
Don't overindulge.
I'll take that last one there.
The faces of infinity are etched in stone, stacked in endless columns. Careful now. The precarious weight of such knowledge could crush an unwise man if he were to pluck a tablet in haste.
Huh? Okay. That's understandable. Okay. Now all I need to do is just get these three, and he'll technically be fully upgraded. That's gonna be pretty cool. Oh. That's that our vestment can be used to summon the hollowed sword and be confound to Felgrin's tower. Can be found inside a chest and crates. Yeah, I heard about that. Can be used to summon the hollowed sword and be confound in Felgrin's tower. Interesting. Okay. Well, I don't technically need to do that because I'm using the hollowed sword. Dude, that's a giant fucking hammer. Oh, I know what's coming. I know what's coming. I know what's coming. I know what's coming. We're about to fight Hattern again.
Okay.
We gonna be fighting him with a giant fucking hammer? Alright. Let's go. Let's go. I think this is technically the last weapon in the game. Just think about it. 4 shells. I only have 3 weapons. Alright, let's see what's going to happen here. I want some good music right about now. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Yep, it's a hammer. It's a bullhorn hammer. Oh, I like that. Oh shit! Okay. Okay, I know what I have to do. I know what I gotta do. Okay, I know it's my power of power. Power is with power. There's your free little lesson of the day. In order to beat power, you gotta be power. I always love fighting Hatter. No, he's pretty fun to use. I can use the hammer. Oh, let me see the hammer. Oh, look at the hammer. Oh, it's a mace. Okay. Alright, so let's go someplace where we're not going to hurt her. Okay. No, I don't want to go that way. Dude, it's a giant base. It's a giant base. Temple grounds. Okay, don't worry about that, okay. Heavy, light heavy? Okay. We got a heavy, light heavy. Light, okay. What's it like doing a heavy attack? Okay. So what if I... Oh, I'd have to do it literally in the first startup. Okay. Do I have a light, heavy, light? Best moves are heavy, light, heavy, and of course the heavy harden. Now when he would hit me, do that. That's not bad. That's not bad at all, really. I want my sword back though. I want my hollowed sword. That'll be fun to use with another character, though. Now upgrade maxed. Tarnished seal runes. Okay. Okie dokie. Alright. That's not too bad, honestly.
Yes. Slowly now.
That's not bad, to be completely honest with you. That's not bad at all. Let's explore around a little bit. I'll try not to fight another boss, because I know it's getting a little bit late. But I want to explore a little bit. This is where we're going to be doing stuff the next time I play this anyways. Where I can farm well caps. That is awesome. I like that. Okay. Hello. Housekeeping. Is anyone around? It's down here. A total foggy death. Something above me. Oh, it's very foggy down there. There's up here that wants to greet me. Oh, another one of you guys. Ooh, look at this guy, Shadow. Look at this son of a bitch. Reminds me of, like, what I would consider a dark race in another game. You know, like the Dark Souls dark race. He kind of fights like one. Now he's dead now. Now it's cool. Ooh. Stuff. Yeah, that's kind of cool. Look, we got some lackeys here. You wonder what? What are you wondering in your head right now? Nelly. Yeah. Oh, we got some recycled food. Eat recycled food. Recycled food. Eat recycled food. I won't go in there right now. I don't think that's a good idea. I'm just glad I was able to get a stream in. I've been wanting to stream for a long while. I'm not gonna do that yet. A dark sign timeline. A timeline where there was no one reborn, no chosen undead. Flame went out, but no one there to tend or defend. A new world was born from the ashes. I used to think that was like leading into Bloodborne. If that makes any kind of sense. But, that would be an interesting, I'm not against that idea, to be completely honest. I'm really not against it. That's not a bad little idea you got there, Shadow. I'm debating if I want to do that event there. That's true. The whole multiverse thing, yeah. Oh, I want to do it so bad, but I don't know what it's going to do. It's a mask offering. You know what? It's only 3:20. Let's do it. Let's do it. I'm not scared of anything. Let's do this. We got a glimpse and a foundry stone. Oh, yeah. We got some gosh boils here. Get out of here. I ain't scared of nothing. Let's go. Let's go, home slices. So there was nothing else to really do in this room. It was just that. Okay. Good to know. See, the thing is, I don't want to go too far. Because I do want to save this for next time. I'm just, like, dipping my toes in some stuff. But, who may have to end up stopping over here. Because I don't want to go through that door yet. I don't want to get myself into another, like, mini-boss battle. So what I'm going to do... I'm going to put myself in front of, you know, this well cap thing. And I'm going to farm a lot of well caps off stream. We're actually going to end right here. I'm going to pause here for a minute. So I want to let everybody know, thank you so much for coming. I really do appreciate it. I'm glad to be back. I'm sorry about the shaky beginning of the stream there. I'll work things out. And everything when it comes to the highlights. I like using Solomon now. Even though I had to give up being able to take poise damage when I was playing as the King, which in case you don't know what I'm talking about, I was able to negate a lot of poise damage, which means I was able to not get knocked down by anything. Even though I've technically sacrificed that, and I have to be more agile and nimble, it's not a bad idea, because I'm able to use my special a whole lot more, which is fan-freaking-tastic. I really like that hammer, though. I mean, the mace. After testing it out and everything, I kind of like that weapon a lot more than the martyr sword. And honestly, it feels a whole lot better than the hammer and chisel, even though the hammer and chisel is mostly used for, like, quickness, you know, blah, 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 blah. But it is interesting. It's very, very interesting. I like the fact that I'm learning more. We'll probably try and do more of this on next Monday. Because also, sooner or later... You know, when Elden Ring hits, that's what I'll be playing on Mondays. And we'll have to put, you know, Mortal Shell to the side and stuff like that. Because here's the thing, is I'm not going to put Elden Ring in the Wednesday slot any, just yet for, like, Soulsborne until I know for a fact that I'll like Elden Ring. Like, for example, when I thought about doing, putting Sekiro in Soulsborne, and I didn't really like Sekiro, I was like, you know what, I shouldn't do that. It's not technically considered a Soulsborne game. Which, technically, from what I've seen from, the trailers, but with, like, a much vaster world, which I can't wait for that. I'm glad that I, pre-ordered for all that, and we'll be able to play it on day one. Fuck yeah. But yeah, next, let me see, my next stream will be on Wednesday. It'll be Soulsborne Wednesday. I'm not sure what we'll do on there. I'm not exactly sure. I'm not sure if I'm going to do something else for Dark Souls 3, or if I want to do more of my stuff on Bloodborne, because I'm never going to run out of Soulsborne content. It's just about, like, one, if I'm going to have internet issues, and to whichever project I want to start or slash finish first. It's all about that. Hell, I still have to do the data mine and developer dungeons for Bloodborne. You know, I'm gonna try and see if I can save that maybe for October of 2022, if I can, because that would be some really nice Halloween content. But we'll see what happens. Either I'll do it on October, I'll do it on July, my birthday month. Be one of those two. When it comes to Friday, I'm not exactly sure. We'll see how the rest of the week goes. But yeah, I'm honestly very happy to be back to live streaming. I was having a lot of live streaming withdrawal when I was in the hospital. And, you know, healing from everything that happened with that. I'm back. I'm good. I'm going to be, you know, off stream aside from, you know, playing some games with my friends and stuff. I'm going to be working on... You know, just me in general. The way my genetics are, though, I'm always going to be a fat son of a bitch. But that doesn't mean I don't have to try and lose some of my weight you know, and things like that. I'm going to be trying to eat more healthy, but you're never going to take away my coffees. You're never going to take those away. But I'm going to be working on myself some more, see where things go with that. As I said, when it came to both Twitter and Facebook, 2022 is the day of Onyx the Game Machine, and it's going to be. Just like in February, I'm going to be debuting a new shirt in the in my merch shop. It is my twist on WWE Roman Reigns' Head of the Table t-shirt. Mine is Center of the Circle, which I absolutely love that. That'll be debuting in February. There's also going to be a sale that's going to go on in the merch shop in February. So if you want to buy the new t-shirt, which I will be having that new t-shirt soon, I'll be wearing that for most of 2022. I just wanted to bring back one of my favorite looks that I like to do, which is my NWO OTGM style, which I will be putting that back up here with my limited edition birthday t-shirt and my my retro techno t-shirt right there. And of course I have my Action Man limited edition t-shirt, which get that while you can if you like that style. When the new t-shirt comes out, I'll be replacing that one with basically like this one, and I'll be wearing the new t-shirt to, like, you know, show it off and everything like that. But yeah, just thought I'd let you know of some of the stuff that's going to be going on in the background. Also, keep in mind, I'll say this once again, I will stay in it during the stream, you are not obligated to subscribe or give any bits or anything like that, but I do have plans that I am going to be saving up for to do on the channel. If you want to help out with that, you know, by all means, subscribe if you want to, or give bits if you want to. All of that will go toward those plans. And also, in case you are part of the subscriber-only Discord, you can also look in my Game Wants list. And you can see what stuff that I have on the side that I want to stream for the channel. A lot of it is mostly things that people want me to stream, but I've told them, you know, if I don't have subscribers, I'll have to save up for it on my own, which is not a problem. If I have to save up for it, I will. But it'll take me a longer period of time to get to your request. You know, that's just the way life is, baby. And that's just the way it's going to have to go. But keep in mind, once again, you're never obligated to subscribe. You're never obligated to give bits or anything of that nature. Just as long as you know, just come on by and hang out, talk to me. I'm here to give a really good and good positive environment while giving you the content that I feel that everyone deserves. Serious content with a little bit of chatterbox type of talking, which is basically what I'm doing right now, except I'm not moving my hand.